But I want to show us something here. How God truly bring deliverance to his people. The Bible says, and they took the ark of God. And you know the kind of mockery that we bring, the kind of sorrow that we bring. Because in 1 Samuel chapter number 4, I think maybe from verse 11, the Bible says, then it happened when they made measure of the ark of God to Eli the priest. The Bible says, immediately he fell behind and he broke his neck and he died instantly at the spot. When he heard that his two sons died in the battlefield, it was not a threat because he knew that the victory behind the Israelite is not based on his own biological son. It's based on the act of God in their midst, which means God's presence in their midst. But when he heard that the ark had been taken, he knew for sure something has gone wrong. And the Bible says he fell down and he died instantly. When one of the wives of the sons heard that the ark has been taken from them, he called it Ichabod, which means the glory has departed from Israel. They knew that the ark of God is the only access for the glory. You understand what I'm saying? And the gathering of the saints is one thing that empowers the church to prevail. But I want us to know that even in our weakness, there is still a mighty God. There is still what? A mighty God. Even in our weakness, there is still a mighty God. Every situation we encounter today does not deny God his personality. It does not reduce the integrity of God. He still remains who he is and he still remains what it ought to be. That is God for him. So the good news there was that the battle the children of Israel could not fight, the Bible said they took that same ark and they took it into. They took the ark into the temple of their own God. What does that mean? They want to mock their God. If the purpose of carrying the ark into their temple, if they're carrying their ark, it's not because they want to mock their God. They would have built a temple for that God, for that ark, because they know that that is the God that Israel serves. But they took it and placed it before their God. In other words, just begin to worship this God. We have made you a subject to this. And the Bible says something. The God whom we sleep, neither sleep, the God whom we choose to serve, neither sleep nor slumber. Even in your weakness, God is still strong. In your absence, God is still God. In your presence, God is still God. In your challenge, God is still God. In your defeat, God is still God. The Bible says to us, they took the ark. And that is what it looks like today. That they have carried God away from the life of the believer. And anytime it looks so, I want you to know that God is up to something. I want to know that God is up to something. And the Bible says they took the ark of the covenant and placed it before their own God. In 1 Samuel chapter, Judges chapter 16. If the gods of the Philistines could not stand the presence of Samson, whose body had been defied by Delilah, no demon, no forces can stand the deity of God. When Samson appeared in the temple, in the palace of the Philistine, and the Bible says he asked them for him to put his two hands on the two pillars. The gospel truth is this: the possibility for you to lay your hands upon them. There is no building under heaven that the two pillars that hold the building will be built together. They are always in an extension from one end to another end. But the Bible says he asked them to put his hand on it to tell you the invisible strength of God. He can stretch the hands of anything. He can do anything from nothing. Don't give up. Our eyes will see the glory of God. Our eyes will see the victory of God. So the Bible says to us here, and when the people arose early in the morning, there was Dagon falling on its face to the earth before the ark of the Lord. Anybody anywhere who intention is to design devices to mock the God of the universe, to mock the living God whom the believer choose to serve, whatever thing that stands behind them shall fall down before